Hello folks, if you see me Retro Restore channel, you see I've bought two new bikes for that channel, and Scrap It Man's over in there. I think he's going to do a video trying to get that TZR running, so let's go have a look what he's up to. Oh, it's a bit cold out here today. Let's have a little walk in here, see what he's up to. Oh, he's doing a video.
It's not cold in here.
Hey, what are you doing? Not cold in here? Of course it's cold in here.
It's nice.
Right, so he's got the TZR here. No doubt you're going to watch all this on his video. I won't show it on my video. You'll have to go over to Scrap It Man's channel. I keep calling him Crap It Man. And no doubt we'll be hopefully attempting to get this started on here. I'm just showing you this. So this is it. And a lot of people, when he showed this on his last video, we just tied it up. We literally just bought this ramp and put it together, and we didn't have no ratchet straps. He's going to get some ratchet straps, aren't you?
Yeah, I'm going to get some, yeah.
You get some cheap ones in Lidl, someone said, so he's going to be getting some of them, and it will be ratchet strapped down on there, so don't worry about that. We only tied it down loosely just to, test it out, basically. And a lot of people also said, yeah, don't rely on these windy things to hold it on the tripod. Well, we know that. Anyway, I'm not going to go on about it, am I?
Well, you already have.
I know. So this is it. This is the little TZR. It's, as you can see, it's very, very rough in there. He's not trying to start it yet, but that's what he's going to do on this video. We've had to take the tank off. Where's the fuel line here?
It wasn't connected to the tank. Look, it's got a 10 amp fuse wedged in it, so.
Oh yeah, look at that, look. How long's that been in there? Look, there's a 10 amp fuse stuck in the fuel line. The tank is, eh? Yeah, can you hear that? I showed on one of my other videos where the rust we had inside of that, but looking underneath it, The seams where they normally go, I don't know. Oh no, it's been plodded up there. Look.
Oh yeah, fiberglass.
Fiberglass there, so this could be not worth restoring. But we won't know till we take it off. It's worth stripping down anyway. But I've actually repaired tanks worse than that before, and he's also got this blinking disc cutter here. Look, it's an ST TS Steel 400. Have you told him? Were you going to tell him how much you pay for that or what?
I haven't said anything.
You haven't said anything, but are you going to tell them? Because a lot of people have been saying that they're worth a couple of hundred quid or whatever. What'd you pay for it?
Well, shall I tell them?
Well, you haven't mentioned it on your channel, so the only way they're going to find out is on Butler's Empire.
20 quid.
20 quid, look. And he actually, first time, well, he didn't start it first time, did he?
No, it took about a good 10 pulls on it.
Yeah. But the thing actually starts up and runs. And anyone who knows anything about these disc cutters know that they hold their price and they're always selling. So he's actually got a blinking bargain there. He paid 20 quid for it. Unbelievable. They've got a water injection there, obviously, where you put your hose pipe on, which lubricates the actual cutting disc when it's cutting. So again, this sort of thing, you know, the plastics will all clean up or even repaint them or whatever. So after a good service, he has run it. It did take some pulling. Obviously, it's going to be a carb stuff. Carb rewind. What is it? Oh, you're doing your favourite pastime again, sitting down. Look at him, look. Unbelievable.
That's what I do.
So, yeah, so that's going to be coming up. I'm sure he's going to restore that one. Well, not restore, I mean, service it and get it going, basically.
And clean, isn't it?
Yeah, but it will come in handy for my patio, which I've got to cut. Yeah, look, this is like a proper blinking workshop now, look.
Oh, don't mess about.
Unbelievable. So we're letting get on with his video now. Let's go and have a look and we'll start my little motorbikes up, what I bought for my channel. Happy days.
I've got something for you in a minute.
What?
I've had some mail coming, but I'm going to open it on my channel, so there's something in there for you as well.
Oh, is there?
Yeah.
Oh, right. Well, okay. Well, you'll have to go over to his video if you want to see what that is. I'll leave a link in the description below for this video, or the one he's doing on this, so that you can pop over and see what someone's bought me and him. Who knows? Not even been opened yet. Soon find out. I'll see you in a minute. Right, well, here's project bike number one. When I say number one, this is the main project bike. It's a Suzuki GSF 600 Bandit. And I've actually been after one of these for quite a while, actually. And I've been watching out. It is the Mark 1 version, 1998, this one. I wanted to get the pre 2000 model because these are the ones I believe are going to be more sought after, because the original, the first one out, sort of thing. It's everything's fine on it. It runs. The only thing is the paintwork's faded on it. Let me show you. So coming over here, you can see, typical with red vehicles, the paintwork is actually well faded on it. Everything on it works for absolutely fine. Everything's perfect. The engine's nice and quiet. The again, the side panels around here is all faded. The stickers are a little bit sort of look a bit naff on it, sort of thing. Although they are the original stickers, but you can see by the towel the how it's really faded there. That's a little thing for an alarm there. I think it's got an alarm on it, this one as well. So yeah, coming around here again, all faded, but everything else on it is actually A-OK. It's got an aftermarket. Oh no, that's the original exhaust, I think. Look, the original Suzuki exhaust on it. A lot of people, when they buy these, they street fighter them, or they modify them. They put sort of take the big front headlight off and they put like two little single headlights on there. They change the handlebar, stuff like that. But no, this one is totally original condition. And as what I always say, I've done my checks on both of these bikes actually before I bought them. You pay to have a check done. I did do a search on some bikes that were going pretty cheaply. When I say cheaply, about what I paid for this. And after you type in the registration number online, you can do a search. You can find out whether it's been stolen, recovered, or write-off, stuff like that. I'll leave a link in the description below the website I use. It's only £2.95 per check, and it's worth doing at the end of the day. So, as I said, I did look at a few other bikes, and I'm always suspicious when someone shows you a bike in an advert and they either cover the number plate up or they hide the number plate. They don't take any shots of the number plate. So one of the first things you want to do is ask them what the registration plate is so that you can do your checks. And I had to do that on a couple of occasions, and both come back. One was a total write-off and one was a cosmetic write-off. But yeah, and it shows you whether they've been stolen, recovered, whether they're on a police registry or what. So always wise to do that if you're spending money buying a vehicle. But anyway, that's what I've done with both of these bikes. So it used to cost about £30. About 20 years ago, you used to have them checks done, and you used to have to pay £30 to £40 to have it, like find companies to do that. You can do it online straight away now for like £2.95. Anyway, so yeah, let's carry on having a little look around it. So yeah, the straightforward bulletproof, these engines are bulletproof, but as you can probably see, it's a bit dirty, and it wants a good engine clean down and all that. The carbs want sort of cleaned off. I will take the tank off. The tank, although there's no dents in it whatsoever, it's got these faded pads on it there, which I'm going to peel off anyway, and I will put a new tank protector on there as well. And the only other problem we've got with the tank is the original Suzuki writing on there have been lacquered over, but the U and the Z has actually come away, or it's peeled off or whatever. So I don't know whether or not the tank had been repainted at some stage, because I'm not sure whether that's original or not. Maybe if anyone's got a bandit, they can actually tell me that. But yeah, I will be painting that and the side panels. Well, I say I might get Jimmy to do it actually. We'll see how we go. But that's going to be repainted red. I'm going to keep this totally standard, totally original if I can. As I say, because this again is going to be sort of an investment bike for me, and one for the channel. There are things that are going to want probably powder coating on it and stuff like that. I will be doing servicing on it, things like doing the brakes, the wheels, the swinging arm will be cleaned, and probably I might even take the swinging arm off and re-powder coat that, for example. So that's something I could do. So there's loads of little service items I can do to this, and yeah, it's going to be a handy one for the channel, because I'll be sort of hopefully bringing it back to standard condition. So let's do no more. Let's put the key in. We'll try and fire it up, shall we? See, things like the handlebars there, look, this can all be cleaned off. They can be taken off the top yoke, for example. I've had people sort of tell me that these can go sort of 150,000 miles, sort of 200,000 miles, I think someone said that they've seen them. So has it got a choke on? Yeah, it's got a choke on there. So the choke you pull down there to bring it on. Let it warm up a little bit. Let's get back on it. Drop the old drop that off a bit. Look at that. Sounds alright, doesn't it? Done 47,000 miles, but the engine is as quiet as anything. As I say, these engines are quite bulletproof on these. I'm well pleased with this. There we go. Lovely. Lovely old job. Here we go. The old 600 Bandit. They do a 1200, but I don't need arm pulling power anymore. I'm well happy with this. Nice for touring around the old country lanes, you know. Yeah, the old tank protector there you want for the zip. There we go. Ticks over and sounds an absolute treat. Four in line carburetors, not fuel injected. I didn't want fuel injection. I'm old school, you see. And it just wants to tidy up, that's all. All the casings are all going to clean up lovely on this, to be honest with you. Listen to that, purrs. I'm well happy with it. I'll do things like change the brake fluid and stuff like that. Obviously do the brakes and that. But yeah, there we go. So that's the Bandit. Ticks over lovely. Okay then, and the next one is this FZ Yamaha 600 Phaser. Again, this is the Mark 1, the first one that come out. And this thing is actually, although it's all wet and dirty at the moment, this thing's actually immaculate. I actually bought this one, not to do any work to it, I bought this one as an investment basically, because I think these are gonna go up in value. Let's show you this one. So coming round it, I mean, the condition of this one, this doesn't need any work done to it whatsoever. It's had about £600 spent on it by the previous owner. New exhaust, new sprockets, service, brakes I think it's had as well. And I'm sure you can agree that the condition, you can see it's been well looked after by, just everything so clean in here, there's no oil residue, even coming round to the back there, I think it's had a new shock on it as well. All in there, places that normally get all crudded up because they don't get touched. Everything's spotless on this one. And, you know, all round the swinging arm. It's got braided Goodrich hoses on it as well, which is a nice little touch. And he's had the 2-4 phaser seat put on it. Not 2-4, I mean, it's just the sports seat on that one. That's not the original seat on there, but yeah, this one is superb, absolutely superb, and doesn't need any work. Again, done around 40,000 miles, but again, these engines are bulletproof. This is the engine that goes into the Thundercat, although it's slightly detuned than the sports bike version, but still very, very pokey engine and very good acceleration. And it's also had new chain and sprockets on this as well, which is another costume. But look how clean everything is, look. Everything's been well maintained, all things like the footrest hangers and stuff like that. It just wants a good valet at the end of the day, you know. So I'm well pleased with this one. So let's put the old keys in here. Try and start this one up. This one's been garaged all its life by the looks of it as well, so. Right. It's got one of those aftermarket gear selector things. He says, don't worry about that. It flashes up 8-12 gears on it or whatever, so that can come off, or whether there's a way to adjust them, I'm not too sure. So I've never had one of them before, so I can't really comment on that. So all right, let's get across it. Stand it up. This thing's so comfortable to sit on as well. It really is comfortable. Again, choke on this one, put that on, and let's have a go. Wow. I don't know if the fuel's on, is it? It's so new, I don't even know if the fuel tap's on. Listen to that. Has it got a fuel tap? I don't know. It's carburation, I know that, but I don't even know if it's got a fuel tap. But there she is, listen to that, look. And again, engine is so quiet. Another bulletproof engine here, so I don't think the crash bars are original as well. I think it's got these put on afterwards, but again, never been crashed. You can see how smooth all that is. And, oh, it's an absolutely lovely tool. Let's say this is gonna be cleaned up and basically put away. I might use this one for a bit, I'm not too sure yet, but I've just ordered a new crash helmet and a new pair of gloves. Because mine, although I've been a biker for many, many years, I've been off of a bike now for about 5 years. And yeah, I'm really looking forward to it. But it's so comfortable. But I've only got little legs and something like this is ideal. Lovely old tool. don't forget, I've had bikes like this before in the past. I had a YZF R1, although back in the early 80s I was a two-stroke person, you know, and riding something like this, this actually reminds me of the power valve that I had, the look of it, quite like the tank sort of thing, the aggressive look on the tank and all that. So yeah, let's just slow that tick over right down there. Right, that's in now. But as I say, it's had this sports exhaust pipe put on it, and until I get it out on the road, I don't know whether or not it needs dyno jetting for the carbs to be set up or whatever, you know, I'm not too sure, but it's just passed an MOT, it's an MOT for a year now. So all I've got to do is put a bit of tax on it, a bit of insurance, which shouldn't be too dear, and you can go buzzing around the old country lanes on it, but it's really, really comfortable. And I'm so pleased now that I've got a bike here, for example, with the higher handlebars, because I've done, let's turn it off for an Eldon. I know you can hear me. I've done the touring. I went to France, through France, into Spain on a YZF 750 Yamaha. And I went with a couple of chaps. This was about 97, I think it was, 1997. And although I had a sports bike back then, they say the YZF 750, driving through to France, into Spain, I was restricted on the top speed, or the speed, or the cruising speed, I should say, because I went with a chap who had a trials bike, which wouldn't really go much above 60 mile an hour cruising speed, and another chap on a Virago 535 Yamaha, which is more like a cruiser. So hours and hours in the saddle for like a good few days on a sports bike, which has got the clip-on handlebars below the top yoke, you're forever like on your wrist all the time because of the wind pressure, because you weren't going fast enough. So I've done all that sort of thing. So, and as I'm getting a bit older as well, I wanted something which has got sort of more upright riding position. And this is exactly what I've got here. So the Bandit and the Phaser, this doesn't need any work doing to it. As I say, this will be cleaned up and put in storage. I might use it for this summer. I'm not too sure yet. I'll play it by ear. But the Bandit there, as you can see, is one that will be featuring on the channel. And hold on for a minute. What's happening here? What you got there?
You've got a bit of a mail call. We've been sent to me. Something in there for you.
Oh, right. Okay. Right, I'll hide your address because we don't want to know who that is. What have we got here then? This is to Martin Butler and family. Let's have a look. This has come from one of your subscribers, isn't it? You said sent to you. And obviously one of my subscribers. So let's have a little look here. Happy Christmas. Christmas wishes. It's been a year to forget, but it's always nice to see you guys pop up on the screen with so much positivity and always bringing a smile to our faces. Merry Christmas and Happy New Year from Igor, innit?
Yeah.
And what's his wife's name? Or his partner?
Kirsty.
Kirsty, of course it is, yeah. Lily and Dave and Fifi, the whole family. Well, that's lovely, Igor. Thank you very much indeed. And what have you actually got us here?
There's a couple of stickers in there.
A couple of stickers? Has he got a channel? Oh, what have we got here? Panettone, yes, we like a bit of that. That'll be going. Well, if it's anything like the other amp, a Snobby sent us, and Mick Mowers, they've nearly bleating gone.
Nearly, they have.
And we've also got another one here. Oh, I've dropped it.
Right about. That's it, put
my
address about.
Well, put your address, put your on show. I like that. Cut that bit out. One for me and one for Sharon, I take it. So thanks very much indeed, Igor, and your lovely family. From one lovely family to another, and I do recognise them stickers now. I do recognise. This is from, let me show you, let's get it out of that. You can keep that. Another YouTuber, which is Cars Exposed. So, he's got a couple of stickers. Look, two different types. I like them. So, yeah, Cars Exposed, I do recognise your channel, bud. And thank you very much indeed. I'll leave your link in the description below this video. And although this is motorbikes, I still got cars and I still do cars, as you well know. Anyway, thank you very much indeed. So let's just show Bert these bikes. Look, come on. Well, as I said to you, I've had the big super bikes before. So these are sort of smaller versions of the super bikes I had. And one bike I did have in probably about 2001. Yeah, about 2001. I had a 1998 R1, the first one that came out, red and white. And that's when I was still working. Yeah, I'll come over here. Let's see what he's doing. And how old were you then when you was 15?
No, 16.
16 years old, right? And I had double garages down there, which we ain't got anymore, on the end of the garden, because I got rid of the end of the garden. And I used to go down to London to work. Hey, where are you going?
Your stickers are blowing away.
Listen to this, you'll love this. And as I'm away for 7 days, Sharon's up here, obviously, but what was you doing with my old one in the garage?
Just running it in.
He was taking it out. Not only that, he was taking people on the blinking back of it. A 16-year-old on a blinking old one. Where did you go on it?
Done about a 15-mile trip. Not far.
Unbelievable. And I had no idea about that until it was years later and he told us about it. Anyway, get on the Suzuki Bandit, start it up. Go on.
It's no TZR though, is it? Can't beat a two-stroke.
Oh, yes. Look at that.
All right,
then. Get a bit of a rev up. Let me walk around it. Look at that. Pull it forward a little bit. Unbelievable. He's actually passed these tests. He had an R6 after he had an Aprilia RS50, wasn't it? You had a scooter as well, didn't you?
Yeah, Piaggio,
NRG. NRG Piaggio he had. That was his first present we bought. No, it wasn't. We bought you the RS50 first of all, didn't we?
That's good.
And yeah, I'll try the other one. Start the other one up. Get on the other one. And then we bought him the RS50. And then he went from an RS50 straight onto a blinking R6. You ain't riding these ones out, boy.
This is more you, it's an old man's bike, this.
Listen to that. Wow. Sounds fruity, doesn't it? What gear are we in, look? Eighth gear, look.
Yeah.
So I don't know whether or not it just sounds a little, I don't know whether it's because it's cold or not. A little bit woolly, you know, so I'm not sure about that one. We'll do a test on that when I get it out on the road. I'm not riding this till the summer anyway, or when it's spring or whatever. I'm not riding it out. I'm a fine weather driver now, you see.
Get it in the polytunnel, I'll sort it.
So I don't know what the rules are on the MOTs now, but I've got the MOT for this one. It's just passed. It's got a brand new MOT on it, and it's just got not an advisory, but it has got a little note saying loud exhaust, but it's passed. It's not an advisory as just such, but yeah, I don't know what the rules are with that anyway, but that's that. So that's the bikes anyway. So there you go.
There you go.
So I'm going to go in the polytunnel now with him. We're going to try and start this little R.
TZR
125. Just as a cold start. It's not been started before, so I've got a little... I've got the Mini Moto petrol tank, because the petrol tank, we can't use that one, and it needs gravity fed. So I've got the little Mini Moto petrol tank, which I'll be finishing very shortly on Butler's Empire, hopefully before Christmas. Not on Butler's Empire, on Retro Restore. So there you go. Two lovely little bikes. This one's going into storage after I've used it maybe for a little bit. That's the one for the other channel, Retro Restore. And I hope you enjoy a little bit of tinkering on this. Don't worry, I'm on the trotter van. I will be doing the trotter van, so don't worry about that. And also finishing other the other little bikes and all that. But yeah, this is something for a bit later on next year sometime. I love a bargain. Right, so what we'll do is put one old Car Exposed stickers on the Wall of Fame. There we go, Cars Exposed. You're on. Oh, I like that. It's like a rainbow effect, isn't it? Cars Exposed there on the Wall of Fame, as with all our other ones there. Don't forget, if you do have got a sticker and you want it to appear on the Wall of Fame on my Retro Restore channel, just send me an email via my About page, and I'll give you my address, and you can send me your channel sticker. We'll put it up there. Happy days. So there you go, folks. Hope you've enjoyed this little tinkering about video. Just pre-Christmas, as you know. If you haven't watched my live stream on Retro Restore, we done just before, well, a couple of days ago, do check it out. Or if you go over to my Retro Hacks channel, there's some like comedy video clips which I put in there. And I'll leave a link in the description below to the comedy clips. I've put them all together in one compilation to save you searching through an hour and a half's worth of footage on the live stream. But it was good fun anyway. We gave away some baseball caps and stuff like that, and we had a lot of fun. Anyway, thanks very much, folks. I hope you've enjoyed this video, and we'll see you hopefully in the new year. I might do one more of these videos before Christmas, or in between Christmas and the new year. We'll see how we go. And until then, we'll see you in the next video. Until then, bye for now.